do what you do in the comfort of your own home, knowing that the things most precious to you are protected. Talk to the Nottingham Building Society today about a free home insurance review. Happy dancing!
Hello everyone, this is Gary with the latest DVD offering from your GMB Nottingham Panthers in association with Virgin Active. Tonight at the National Ice Centre, we welcome bottom of the table Hull Stingrays. Impeded by injury, they lost another guy in their shutout defeat at Manchester 24 hours ago. The bad news from our viewpoint is 24 hours ago we held a 3-goal lead and then we didn't turn up for the second or third periods against the Basingstoke Bison. And the cup we so proudly won last year is now a dream for next season, not this season. We can't win it again this year. Looking ahead to this one, it's time to get back on track. It's time to win the game. It's time to put in 60 minutes.
The players will be back after this short message from the Nottingham Building Society, headline sponsor of the Nottingham Panthers. Are you saving for your first home and thinking about getting on the property ladder? Are you aged 18 to 39? Would you like to see how you could get up to £1,000 free per tax year for your first home? Let us tell you about the Lifetime ISA. The Lifetime ISA is a savings account for 18 to 39 year olds who want a little extra help with their future savings goals. You can use it for your first home or wait until you're 60 and use your savings for retirement. The government will give you a 25% bonus on your savings. So you save £100, you get £25. You save £4,000, which is the maximum per tax year, you get £1,000 free, paid straight into the account, plus interest. You can open an account with just £10 online at thenottingham.com. Ineligible withdrawals are subject to a government charge of up to 25%. Check the terms and conditions for more information. Now, back to the Nottingham Panthers.
All right, folks, here we go with the action. GMB Nottingham Panthers versus the XL Hull Stingrays. This one sponsored by the Big Wheel, turning transport around in Greater Nottingham and sponsoring our second period season-long Win a Star Prize shootout slingshot slapshot competition. Johnny Pushtie makes his debut for the season with me on the microphone, and Steve Wilkinson, 20 years together with Jackie, the train robbers didn't get that long, is behind the lens. The light's about to go up on this one. Referee is Marco Coonan. Davis Parley and Curtis Cruikshank on netminding duty. Our fear Hull Stingrays, Johnny, are going to get the backlash from what happened to Nottingham last night. Coach Nielsen had them in for an early doors meeting this morning and they're all arriving in shirts and ties and they're all calling me Mr. Moran on the way into this one.
That's always good, nothing like a little bit of discipline. I think it's probably what the team needs at the minute. Something to get them on the right track again, Gary.
Disappointing is the understatement of the year for last night's result, which knocked Nottingham out of the Challenge Cup. So it's time to concentrate on the league. And that starts right now against Hull Stingrays, who themselves are missing three or four players through injury. Glower against Myers. Glower wins the first draw of the night. Brendan Cook tries to get to Slanina, helping out on defence, the forward for the Hull Stingrays. It's in deep to Nottingham territory. Matt Myers takes the pass off the boards, tries to chip it forward to Brendan Cook. It's not back to the D, he's Ruman Nadur. Myers out to Matt Myers. He tries to dance through, Hull pick it off, bring it the other way, gain the halfway line. Snap stick on Lee Mitchell, the Brit forward. He goes for a change, Nadur gets it forward to Galbraith. Sweet hands when he gets them going, gets it out to Matt Myers. Over his stick though, Constantine couldn't get to it, but Hull have got it now. He's Jeff Glower. Over halfway, chips it in, Hull would have been caught offside. Konstantin Kalmykov, the former Panther. So it's a change for the Hull Stingrays and Nottingham send out. The Clark Berg in line with Richardson. Save by Curtis Cruikshank, standing well out of his net. You'll see Kevin Bergin there in a full mask. He's protecting a damaged nose. But word is, if Costadine, who's had words with Bergin throughout this season, wants to do anything, Bergin will happily remove the face mask.
Just a cheap shot there by one of the old players, Gary, on Richardson. Oh, and he's going to the bench.
He's going to the box for that. That's Costadine, I believe, sitting down for the bump, and it was no more than a bump.
Box is sponsored by PWP, always controlling the temperature, whatever the situation. And that puts the GMB Panthers in.
Soho Stingray straight to penalty kill duty. Gamenyuk just back from injury this weekend, helps it forward, and then it's sent down the ice by Matt Reynolds. The unsportsmanlike conduct penalty that puts Nottingham to the power play in an early opportunity to take a stranglehold on this one. Paul Moran gets it to the corner, but only as far as Johan Molin takes the big hit. Still in position, blocking the route, Johan Molin. Bergin to the side of the net, no tip from Richardson. Turns it into the corner, Clark's beaten to it. Hull don't get it out. Keep it in low. Now they get it out. Good penalty killing by the Stingrays.
Very good, they held the form there well. And we just couldn't pull them out of position, could we?
Molin inside to Bergin, but he's manhandled, but it's kept in the zone by Corey Nielsen. Danny Myers has advanced, he's ready for the one-timer. Has to corral the puck first. And it took him time, but there's still a full minute to go on the power play for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Interception, though, on the feed out to the blue line. Jamie Thompson involved. He gloves it, puts it down, and bats it down the ice. And 44 seconds to go on the penalty kill for the Hull Stingrays. And now 38 seconds of PP, power play, man advantage to the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Matt Myers loses out. There's a chance of a break here. Kalmykov winds up, big shot, saved by Davis Paul. He's not sure where it is, but the puck stays with him like glue. And it's a face-off at the other end of the ice from where the Nottingham Panthers should be camped out on a power play.
Well, we haven't really stamped our authority on that power play, Gary. Let's hope the guys pull it together a little bit more.
Face off to the left of Davis Pauly. Nottingham win the draw. Dan Tessier getting it back to Corey Nielsen, on to Danny Myers and back to Dan Tessier. Tess has a look, drops it off to Myers, gets it back. Good movement by the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Right to the back door, tip from Curtis Cruikshank, so vital. It's rolling around on the top of the goal. The flop in has led to danger for Hull and pressure for Nottingham. Stingrays get Costadine back from the box. Nottingham still with momentum. It's played round though. Tessier lets it go by and it's picked up by Hull. It's a 3-on-2. Mitchell drives the net. Costadine backhands it in low. He's dealt with though by Matt Myers. Matt Myers gives Costadine a shot. Matt Myers is going with Costadine. Costadine tries to jump in. Matt Myers, not normally a scrapper. Costadine obviously fancying his chances against the Welsh guy. He's big and strong though, Matthew. If he starts throwing them, he'll come back strong. Here comes the Welsh wizard. He's taken a few shots. He's not a scrapper, but he's big and strong. He's holding his man in there. He hasn't backed down. He's doing a job for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Costadine picks his spot. Costadine did not win that one. That was a win for a Brit who doesn't normally fight.
Yeah, well, that was good. That was excellent. That's perhaps what we need, a bit of heart there, Gary.
That's pride. That's passion. That's what was missing last night.
Well, he's done it. Hopefully he's going to have woke the Panthers up. Start getting the roar back into our throats, Gary.
You saw there why Matthew doesn't often fight, because it's not his game. But what a great job he did.
If you're in trouble with your accounting system. It isn't too bad though, did it?
That's what I don't like about players. You have your scrap, you get your penalty, you go, you sit down. Whatever the fans shout, whether it's banter or abuse, you sit there.
Yeah.
That's what a pro does.
So what's your story with Bergin?
He's got a damaged nose from the game up in Newcastle, but Costadine, the guy that's gone to the box, is an irritant as far as the GMB Nottingham Panthers are concerned, and Kevin Bergin is willing to take the full goldfish bowl off if Costadine has the guts to go with a guy who is a genuine fighter when he wants to be.
Penalties to the Stingrays, number 27,
Jason Costadine. Oh, well, Bergin will surely oblige him.
5 minutes each for fighting.
Well, let's not lose sight of the fact that we've had an exciting start to this one, but it's still 0-0. But it's early doors. David Clark shields the puck, protects it. It was high and wide. Into the corner of Curtis Cruikshank. Matt Reynolds goes to corral Bruce Richardson. Gets a stick in. The puck's up in the air, lobbed. Paul Moran with Kevin Bergen, and Hull come away with it. He's Paul Moran. Proud parents watching tonight, Johnny.
We are today, and as well as that, a really good friend of mine who I've known since he was a very young man.
Well, Nadir's been penalised for a hit from behind on Esders. And now the Hull Stingrays get a power play opportunity.
Just out of the spot that young Matthew Myers has done has kept us going.
Well, Nottingham have a good penalty kill unit, but look at the shortness of the bench for Hull. They've literally got six spare skaters with one in the box. So that would be seven when they haven't got a player in the box and five on the ice. They're desperately struggling with injuries and problems.
I'm sure Corey will have noticed that and told the guys to play it the
Having
way.
Said that, Basingstoke had something similar last night. Came from 3-0 down to knock us out of a cup we won last year. Blocked by Tessier, stops the shot getting to the net. Aaron Wilson takes it into the corner. Tries to protect it from Corey Nielsen. Corey Nielsen battles on the boards, wins the puck, gets it to Dan Tessier. Dan Tessier fires it all the way down to Curtis Cruikshank, the former Panther. Wilson gets it forward. I'm not sure forward Lee Mitchell knew it was there, and he doesn't. Mark Levers comes forward with it, but just gives it up softly, and he comes Mitchell with the puck. Oh, it's a steal by Brendan Cook. Poor play by the Stingrays, trying to overcook it in their own zone. And they've done it again. Kalmykov gives it away. Moline fakes the shot. This is good shorthanded play, and he plays it back to defence and captain Danny Myers. Off the glass, all the way down the ice. And more than half of the power play has been killed. Good forechecking, you could say, by Nottingham, but dreadful breakout by the Hull Stingrays.
Well, they haven't got the game together yet. Just
and they've given it away again. Slanina settles it down, gets it to Gamenyuk. He fires it across to Matt Reynolds. We've had 5 minutes of the game, and most of this Stingrays power play has been totally ineffectual. Sent down the ice, this would be a 2-on-0 unless Curtis Cruikshank gets to it first. He gets to it, plays left defence for a while, and Gamenya calmly takes it back.
He did a hell of a job there, Cruikshank.
Well, they were well sold out. Oh, and there's another giveaway, and it's straight to Bruce Richardson. He's the opening goal. Pad save by Cruikshank. Cruikshank has kept his side in it. He said to me on his way into the building, if we can get through the first 10 minutes, even Stevens, we might be okay. They know they're up against it, against a full-strength Nottingham. Nottingham get their man back. Hull have the puck. Coming down the left wing, Wilson. Over halfway, diagonal dump. Behind the play, Glower comes on for Reynolds. Thompson takes his break. And the only other line that can come out for the Hull Stingrays makes the trip onto the ice. Kevin Bergen winds up for the shot. Interception from Wilson, goes high, wide and handsome. Oh, bad bounce off the boards. Paul Moran gets to it, can't get it out of the zone. Hull get another chance. David Clark keeps it in. Paul Moran reads the play, has a look, threads it through to Glower. Good pass. Glower takes it left wing. He's a threat. Glower, he scored a hat-trick up in Edinburgh last weekend, the 32-year-old. He's their leading scorer from last year. He's got a hat-trick last week on a losing team. David Clark stuck a leg out there, got away with a hit on Kalmykov. I'd be infuriated if someone did that to one of our guys.
Well, if we do it, it's not so bad, is it?
No, it's a fair check if we do it, Johnny.
His leg was lazy.
Mark Richardson works his way through. He's hooked back door. Got to be. Curtis Cruikshank gets the stick down and makes a wonder save. Apparently he made a wonder save. It's behind him. It's off the back of the keeper. And it's in effect an own goal. Cruikshank made another wonderful save. And the guy at the right of the goal in the black, I think, is Paul Moran. He tried to back it off the line and it only hit Cruikshank, who was reversing towards the goal line, and it went in.
That was one of them plays.
It's Gamenyuk. Gamenyuk scored the own goal off his own keeper's backside. Panthers will get the credit though. 1-0 Nottingham at 7:17. Cruikshank didn't get his wish. He didn't get to the 10-minute mark without the dam being burst.
He has made some incredible saves, Gareth.
Galbraith shapes up for the shot off the shoulder. And Danny Myers gets the credit for the goal.
Assisted 14, Jake Galbraith, and 8,
Our 40 gets an assist, as does number 8 Matt Myers, but we all know it was 40 Gamenyuk who fired it in off his own keeper's backside. Mark Richardson gets past Matt Reynolds and gets down the left wing, goes down, Paul Moran's underneath. Ties the man up but not the puck, it's back to the front. Interception by Hull and they get it round, but only if Suarez Nick Tony's at point. He sends it in low, Galbraith gets to it behind the net, feeds the front, tries to feed the front, doesn't get it out front. Cook is rubbed out of the play and Reynolds brings it forward for the Hull Stingrays. Gets it over halfway, sends it in and goes for a line change. This has to be one-way traffic now. Nottingham have got three full lines, spare bodies in all departments, and Hull have got one spare body if they've got nobody in the box.
And Hull are looking as though the legs have already gone, Gary, the way we're going at him.
Well, they had two-line hockey last night in Manchester.
That's why. They've got no spark at all. Whereas our guys are flying. Richardson, number 9, there's nobody to stay with him.
It was a lucky goal. We'll take it, though. 1-0 Nottingham. Sponsored by the Big Wheel.
How many times have we had fantastic plays and not a goal? Whereas there, we didn't have the best of plays.
Good saves from the Crooker, though.
Yeah.
Cruikshank, who was boxing in the gym through the summer in Nottingham with the likes of Carl Froch, although when he did go in the ring with Carl Froch, he caught him a good one and it didn't half hurt. Froch will be here in a couple of weeks' time and afterwards will be Nottingham's next world boxing champion.
What, Crookie went in the ring with him?
Yeah, boxed with him. Did well for a while, but then Froche turned on the style. I'll tell you a story about a reporter that went in the ring with Froche in a moment, but this is Nottingham on the attack. Ruman Nadir gives it away to Jeff Glower, and Glower has a luck. They're trying to high post it. Ruman Nadir knocks it out of midair. Good hand-to-eye coordination. And it's allowed Molin to send it to Tessier. Back to Molin. Back door. Got to beat. Cruikshank gets down and across.
Just a little goals bit behind
him. Goal's just off
there.
Its moorings. Goal's just off its mirrors. Yeah, some boxing correspondent, ex-amateur boxer from, I think, one of the heavies, one of the big papers, the broadsheets, Johnny. You don't read those papers. Anyway, he goes in the ring with Carl Froche at the end of an interview and thinks he's doing all right. And then he hurts Froche. Apparently Froche held him up, beat him up and hurt him bad.
hey, now that's professional.
All right, he's Corey Nielsen. Floats one in, it deflects around. Gamenyuk and Paul Moran combine and it's back to Gamenyuk. Gamenyuk off the boards, gets it down the ice. It bounces kindly for Corey Nielsen and he has a look. And that was James Cook, another former Nottingham boy. Oh, bad ricochet, bad play. Corey Nielsen steps in, shoots through traffic, but not through the pads of Paul Moran. He's limping, but he blocked the shot. Slashing is the call against Corey Nielsen. He skates straight to the box like a pro and sits down.
Panthers Home Penalty Box sponsors are Solutions for Accounting. If you're in trouble with your accounting systems, call Solutions for Accounting.
There he goes, he's skating it off.
Paul Moran trying to skate off the knock from the shot, which hit him in the pad. Slava Kulikov behind the bench, along with Rick Strachan for the XL Hull Stingrays. This is a big kill now, because there's only one goal between the sides, and Hull's last power play was abysmal.
You've only got, as you said earlier, you've only got to look at the benches. If I was Rick Strachan, I'd be pretty worried about the size of that.
Well, Kerr's out injured, Neumeier's out injured. That's his top line of defence. His top two import defencemen are out injured. Slava Kulikov, his top Brit, is out injured. Gamenyuk's just come back from injury. Rebound, goal, Jeff Glower, 1-1 scoreline.
You said him. You said earlier, watch him, and he always comes up with big goals, doesn't he?
He's one of those players. 9:45, Corey Nielsen took the slashing call mid-ice, and on the power play, Hull Stingrays have tied it up. And now Curtis Cruikshank is 15 seconds away of reaching his number one goal, which was to get to the 10-minute mark on even Stevens. Kalmykov did the work, shot, save, rebound. Glower was all alone, no one was with him.
So you've got to do is be there at the right time, right place.
Good feed forward, Jamie Thompson. Very Christian man, so I was reading about him. Skill play, he's got over 300 pro goals though. Nottingham have to chip it in. Wilson got it to the far boards, but Jed Galbraith's kept it in the danger zone for Nottingham. Cook sends it on for Matt Myers. Slanina gets there and trips up Matt Myers with a stick between the legs and both feet just about. Now it's Nottingham on a power play on that hooking call at 10:22 against Slanina.
Matt always reminds me, he's one of the deceptive players. You don't think he's tough, but he always gets in the other team's faces. Just by doing that kind of, what he just did there.
He's very strong. Words as they go to the team benches between Endur and Clark and Costadine. But he's strong. Matthew's really strong. You know, he works as well as plays, and if he played full time and was in the gym as often, I mean, he makes up with the gym work on his own time and what have you, but you just have to imagine, you know, in his years as a student, you always imagine that Mac did get better and better as the season wore on, as he got fitter, etc. And you just imagine if he was with the team full time, he'd get there quicker or at the same time as the rest of the boys. And that's, I'm not knocking him, he'd be even fitter than he is, if you see what I mean.
I suppose you'd be able to say he'd be unstoppable.
Hull force it out, battling on the boards, but only as far as Corey Nielsen, the retreating Corey Nielsen. He sends Johan Molin away and he nails the tape of Kevin Bergen and out to Richardson. Feeds it right across. Clark lets it come off the boards, right to the front, pad save. Kevin Bergen couldn't get the redirection on it. We've had 11 minutes of the first period and we've got 80 seconds of power play still to come for Nottingham. This is Molin. Well, Hull looking for discipline from their four on penalty kill. Panthers looking for inspiration from the five on the power play to take the lead, retake the lead. Bergen tries to steer it. Penalty coming up against Paul Moran. Molin leaves it for Costadine to touch. The tripping penalty called against Paul Moran. 59 seconds of five on three power play. Here's the game, first period, for your GMB Nottingham Panthers.
Nice, clever move there by Molin to leave the puck so the whole player could touch it, so we get a quicker 5-on-3.
Sponsored by PWP. Nobody gets past PWP security and access systems. Penalty to the Stingray.
So 59 seconds of power play coming. Tripping's the call against Paul Moran.
Stingray's 42. There are 2 minutes for tripping. Penalty timed at 11 minutes, 23 seconds. 1-1-2-3.
Well, you don't keep a box on a 3-on-5 kill.
No.
They win the puck though and get it down the ice.
Tried to get rid of it though, yeah.
Tight triangle and almost a straight line. Reynolds is the forechecker, if there's such a thing, on penalty kill. Here's the switchback play. Clark with a big blast off target. Pad save, I think that was going bottom corner, and the deflected shot goes all the way down the ice. Davis Parley scurries out of his ice, gets to the puck, gets it forward to Clarkey. Tessier takes it forward, keeps it in the zone. Picked off though. Reynolds sends it down the ice. They get a man back in 15 seconds. Lots of time for Molin. He's dealing in. He turns away back to Corey Nielsen. He winds up for the big shot. The interception dive from Glower. He got a piece of it. It went upstairs. Wilson reacts first to the loose puck. Hull Stingrays get a man back. Slanina stays on the ice and plays defence as part of a four-man penalty kill unit, but still an opportunity to take the lead for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Brendan Cook going into the corner. Gamenyuk one-handed, flaps at it, slaps at it. It's come all the way around to Tessier this time, though. Tessier turns it in low. Gamenyuk does enough to stop Matt Myers getting there. Hull get to it again. More good kill from the Hull Stingrays. Last kick of the cap by the Panthers. Mark Richardson turns it to the corner to Brendan Cook. Under pressure from Hull, still gets it to Mark Richardson. Goes for the back of the net. Turns it in low. They're getting the other guy back in a few seconds, but Nottingham have the momentum. Galbraith to Leavers. Leavers has a look. First weekend back after injury. Missed a game after injuring a leg. Hull have picked it off. Flicked it down the ice. Came off the, well, the linesman from Billingham says it came off the bench. Might have come off his tummy. That was a big kill for Hull, Johnny.
Yeah, very. They seem to be playing the penalty kill very well on each attempt they've had. Rick Strachan must have him drilled very well at this. And they're used to getting a lot of penalties, Gareth.
Slanina, after conversations with the coach, goes on defence. Paul Moran slips on for a shift up front. Something to do with the lines that have to be on the ice when the play restarts. Paul Moran goes straight back. Change of personnel. Doesn't get it out of the zone though. Nottingham putting the pressure on. He's Bruce Richardson behind the net. Plays it off the back of the net. Cleverly gets it back. Nick Tonies was wide open at the back door. Nottingham didn't get it to him. David Clark, robbed by Paul Moran, gets it down the ice. Gets a mouthful for his trouble. Doesn't matter if you're a mate when you're playing against each other. For 60 minutes, you're not friends, are you, Johnny?
No. Different coloured shirts. Not good.
Glower shields Bergin. Wilson gets to it. Bounces off a stick, but Bergin's offside, so Hull have time to settle themselves this time. Slanina. Long wide pass to Costadine. Flicks it past Corey Nielsen. Corey Nielsen one-hands him in the chest. Hull pick off the clearance. Back to the front. Clever play, wasn't it? Clever play by young James Cook of Nottingham to try and catch the keeper out. That could have rebounded any which way, as it was. Davis Parley had it covered, and the scoreboard remains 1-1 in this one in the BMI Baby Elite League, sponsored by the Big Wheel.
Very lucky. We need something to happen down there. I think we need a spark igniting again, because it seems to have gone a little bit flat, Gary.
Backs to the wall, shorthanded. I mean, some of our best games for Nottingham were when Paul Adey was the coach and we were down to like six forwards and 3D. I remember we went to London at the end of a season with Paul and two 17-year-olds on the wings on the second line, and one line of forwards up front and 3D, and the D were taking turns to play 10-minute shifts and what have you, and you just do what you can. Well, Hull are doing what they can so far. At the moment it's a 1-1 game, but Nottingham by far the better team. Tessier gets it in low. Gamenyuk reads his man, pucks underneath them. Gamenyuk turns it to the corner. Glower doesn't react as quickly as Levers, but wins the tussle on the boards, and off the boards gets it to neutralise. Ruman Nadir, with help from Moline, gets it across to captain Danny Myers. We've got less than 5 minutes to go first period. It's a 1-1 game, an entertaining game. And Nadir gets past Glower and Mitchell and gets it forward to Brendan Cook. Curtis Cruikshank comes a long way out. I like Curtis Cruikshank as a person. I like Curtis Cruikshank as a goalkeeper when he's playing well. He's as good as anyone in the league. I know you can say this about any goalie, but Crooker is as good as any goalie in the league. He made a save for us in the Continental Cup. There was a still photograph that went around the world of him making this incredible diving save with the paddle and knocking one out. Apparently he made one like that in Manchester last night. And when he's on form, Hull Stingrays can be on form.
I just think he's it. Like you say, firstly, he's a great guy, and secondly, he is a really good goalie.
He's not so good at the boxing against Carl Froch, though.
Well, now, but I wonder how Froch is doing goal, eh?
Oh, rebound comes out front. Cook reacts to it first. Sent down the ice for safety. Paul Moran has a look, plays it across to Gamenyuk, the big bear of a Ukrainian. Off Kalmykov's skate, goes in low. Tonies gets back to it. Well, that's a rewind the tape, folks, and see how icing shouldn't be called, but never mind. 4:08 to go, sponsored by the Big Wheel. They're the people that advertise things like the trams and the buses. Sustainable transport systems, as it's called. It's not, you know, a phrase that rolls off the tongue, but basically they're trying to keep a level of poison down and the number of cars out. Johnny, don't look at me like that. It doesn't mean they're forced to be vegetarians. Steve and Jackie, cameraman, celebrating 20 years together this weekend, son.
Oh, so where's his medals?
Well,
oh, who said that?
No. He doesn't even get parole, you know.
I think Steve's a great guy. He's one of the bravest men I know.
Well, do you know what? He's going to film for 60 minutes tonight, and if the boys had played for 60 minutes in Basingstoke last night, we wouldn't be feeling as we do on this Sunday in November. Cruikshank had to be alert to that one through a lot of traffic. A lot of traffic. And he got to it.
As you said, he's a good goalie, and he's what's holding him in the game at the minute, because we have been all over them.
Like a rash. 16 minutes gone, but it's 1-1 on the board.
Well, we're still both chugging on the same marrow bone, though, eh?
There's a butcher's phrase for you. Incoming. High sticks the call.
Panthers home penalty box.
David Clark on Costa Dine.
If you're in trouble with your accounting systems, call Solutions for Accounting, Nottingham's award-winning Sage business partner. Penalty to Panthers, number 5 to David Clark. 2 minutes.
We know what happened on the last power play. Shot, rebound, back of the net, Glower, 1-1. Big kill coming up. Levers and Tessier. And Corey Nielsen giving Costa Dine a slap round the back of the calves. Stretches, gets to it. Matt Reynolds gets the puck to Costa Dine. Costa Dine tries to nutmeg Nielsen. Deflects around, bouncing clearance by Nick Tonies, goes all the way down the ice. That's a quarter of it dealt with. Cruikshank rags the biscuit round, through the legs by Reynolds, easily picked off by Nottingham. Levers is wide open. Myers to Richardson, right through to Levers. He's in open water, but he didn't get the shot away, turns it in low. Being used sparingly and gingerly as he gets that leg back in shape. Stingrays give it away, get it back. They're offside, they have to regroup. They haven't.
So what's the story of the leg, Gary? How long do you think he's going to be before?
It was one of those things. It was knee to knee. It was just knee to knee. He was in the wars. It was in the Belfast game. And he was really in the wars. He got battered from pillar to post, start to finish. And eventually he collided knee to knee. I didn't think there was anything malicious in it at all. And he just came off worst. It was just one of those things. Weren't sure at first whether it was going to be... He missed the third period as a precaution. Weren't sure if it was going to be a precaution. In the end, he had to miss a weekend, but he's back now. Well, it's not so much a power play as whose turn is it to go on when you've only got one spare skater over and above two lines, but he's Kalmykov with the puck for the Hull Stingrays. A little bit of cycling from the Hull Stingrays. They've got the spare body, remember. Kalmykov gets it in low to Mitchell. Mitchell to the far point. Gamenyuk strides forward. Low save, rebound, it's there. Slanina can't get to the rebound this time. Panthers breathe a sigh of relief. Slanina's got the puck in the corner, though. Gets it back to the big Ukrainian. Tried to get a steer from Mitchell. Didn't come. Better looking shift this time. Kalmykov fakes the shot. Richardson with a shot. One timer. Kalmykov gets it back. Slanina save. Good save by Davis Parley. Great save. And Hull have failed on this power play, but not for the want to try in this time. Kalmykov. Panthers still under pressure. Rebound now. Nottingham get a chance to clear. Matt Myers sends it down as if on penalty kill duty. Fresh legs coming out from Nottingham.
Well, you've got to say that was an impressive power play.
Did everything but score. We've got a 1-1 game. Thompson helps it on, but only as far as Nick Tonies. Picked off by Aaron Wilson. Long shifter, Gamenyuk. He's still on there. Thompson turns it out to the left wing. Costa Dine and Tonies in a tussle. Nielsen, too strong. And Nottingham come out with a puck. He's Bergin. Bergin's shot eventually goes high, but he's still got the puck in the corner. I was watching behind the play as well.
Corey seems to have a real battle going on with Constantine.
Well, the whole team doesn't like Costa Dine.
Costa Dine, sorry.
Yeah. Last minute, Paul Moran gets it forward to Jamie Thompson. Jamie Thompson has a look. Oh, fires it behind Costa Dine. Brendan Cook. Bergin comes in. It's flicked forward. Well, with everybody clinging onto the boards and lifting their feet off the air, in the air, no too many men call against the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Cruikshank goes to the corner, helps it on its way. Levers has read the play. He's got there first. Mitchell hits him, but the puck's with Jade Galbraith to Nadeau. Shot blocked. Galbraith can't latch onto that one from Cook. Mitchell gets to the loose puck first. Last 10 seconds of the period. Again, Hull pay the price for trying to dipsy-doodle and tiptoe out of their own zone. But here comes the Hooter. That'll go down as a good scoreline for the Hull Stingrays. But a good period of solid work from the GMB Nottingham Panthers. At least no one's taken a night off, at least yet. It went wrong from the end of the first period onwards in Basingstoke. Let's hope that's not going to happen tonight against the Hull Stingrays. Sponsored by the Big Wheel, turning Nottingham's transport around. Filmed by Steve Wilkinson with commentary from Johnny Pushdie and Gary Moran. That's the end of 20 minutes of interesting action. And we've got a GMB Panthers 1, XL Stingrays 1 scoreline with 40 minutes to come.
So I'm walking through, and as I'm going out for warm-up, I'm like, I remember saying to myself, walking down the tunnel, this is it, right? I'm gonna walk on the ice. There's gonna be people in the stands coming to watch me play. So I step on the ice. I am not 2 feet on the ice, and I hear, Leach, you suck!
You start to think, what was I doing when I was 20 years old?
Right. Hey, I didn't think I was gonna be doing that when I was 20 years old either, so.
Unfortunately, like you said, it's one of those moments where Julian comes up big when he needs to.
Oh, God. Dude, let's not pump his tires.
So I went out and I started lining up and I started going the wrong way against my own goalie because I was so nervous I didn't even realize. And everyone was yelling at me and then I was like, oh, my God.
Before we carry on, I will say that you have the most delightful accent that has been on this show. I've never had someone with that kind of Bostonian accent. So this is wonderful.
Yeah, hopefully you can understand me.
Well, I tell a story in the book about cycling with our team at
one point. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. You should pick up the book. But
no, I think the first day he showed up was a good indicator of Langer. He walked in, and instead of carrying a hockey bag, he was carrying a duffel bag.
Don't do the mistake I did once, just leaving the ice, being the only rookie to not stay. I heard about it for months, let me tell you.
And you mentioned them a minute ago. What did you make of Johan's white skates when you first saw them?
Well, they're not for me, but I got the
You had a fight in a game.
Oh, God.
Now, well...
Now, all of a sudden, about after 5 minutes of doing drills and stuff, the puree obviously starts to come down onto his face and everything. So, anyways, he takes off back to the boards and he's throwing water on his head and drinking it, and everyone's looking at him like, what's wrong with him? You know, like, what's going on? I never told anybody, right?
He gave an assist on our goal to someone in the bench. Let's go. Second period action underway here at the National Ice Centre. Nottingham need to do better on the goal scoring front, but I thought the effort and commitment was there. And here's Brandon Cook trying to get something going. Nottingham keep it in the zone. They flick it past Kalmykov. Matt Myers and Slanina on the boards. Matt Myers is going to win that tussle of strength 9 times, if not 99 times out of 100, 9 times out of 10. It's turned right across, Nottingham with the pressure, early doors in the start of the second period. Ruman Adur gives it away though. Flicked off the backboards by Cook and Kalmykov collects. Played for us a few years ago now, always liked him. Smooth skating, goes for the backhand off the side of the net, collects his own rebound, spins and turns, takes it behind the net. It's across to Kosterdine. Kosterdine gets it in low, but Matt Myers has the puck and softly backhands it to Itcho Ruman Adur. This one sponsored by the Big Wheel. And Nottingham need to get their wheels going. Brendan Cook leaves the puck behind. But Reynolds gives it away. It's turned in low. Paul Moran deals with Galbraith and Bergin fires it across the crease. Richardson goes to collect the stray puck. Curtis Cruikshank gives it away. The shot's blocked by Paul Moran. And it's led to this breakout 3-on-2. Big Pashka Menyuk joins in the attack. It grinds to a halt on the right wing. Kosterdine winces. Nice backhand to David Clark. Into the skates of Reynolds though. Corey Nielsen fires it across the front of the crease. Richardson It's shooting gallery time. Deflected down by James Cook. I mean, it's all Nottingham, isn't it, Johnny, at the start of this period?
It's all Nottingham, but it was like that through most of the other period. Just we
Paul Moran intercepts, sorry, Johnny, to interrupt. Paul Moran intercepts, wins the puck and sends them away again. Costadine through the legs just to Paul Moran. Loses control and Reynolds turns it in and it's a change on the fly and a good defensive shift from the whole Stingrays. You feel that Nottingham could break the Curtis Cruikshank dam and the floodgates could open, but until the dam's broken, this one's going to be tight.
I'm sure Corey would have spoke to him the way he wants him to play in between the periods.
Oh, the wicked bounce just fell kindly for Esters. Not perfectly, but it bounced and ricocheted back off the edge of the puck. Tessier gets enough on it to get it across to Moline. Diagonal dump. Thompson beats Levers to it, flicks it up into the air, but not past point. Nick Tonies keeps it in. It's off the backboards. Cruikshank knocks it down, but Moline gets to it first, and it's come to Tessier right to the front. Big save to deny Levers. And he'll flick it out of the zone. And it's a bit like the little Dutch boy with his finger in the dam at the moment, isn't it?
It is. I don't know whether that was a really good save or it was just in the way.
You always give the goalie the credit. I'm used to that now with Davey Graham having done all the other games on commentary. That one, Pete Hunt headed that one. He didn't get two for flinching. I'm not sure he knows it hit him, but Galbraith put his hand on it. It was a hand pass from Jade Galbraith to Pete Hunt. We're just welcoming Jerry Watson to the arena. He's in my old seat, Steve, if you could have a quick look down in the bowl. Jerry Watson, he's 82 years of age. He played for 5 years in the 50s. And he stopped playing last year. Guess how old he is?
80.
82, I told you. You were supposed to just say 82 and look like a knowledgeable person.
No, I don't.
You weren't going to cheat. You're too honest.
I'm not cheating.
Warm reception for Jerry Watson. Brendan Cook gets it forward. Jade Galbraith with a soft hand shoots through the legs of defenceman Gamenyuk. Matt Myers twists and turns, gets it in low. Nottingham got spare bodies. Brendan Cook hits the side of the net. Matt Reynolds reacts first, plays it off the boards to Kalmykov. Kalmykov off the boards, gets it down the ice. Roman Nadir goes back to get it. We've had 4 minutes of the second period, sponsored by the Big Wheel. It's still 1-1 on the board, but it's been all Nottingham Panthers. That one's just floated in. I think it was Konstantin Kalmykov that just kind of let it go past him. Reynolds flicks it down the ice, or tries to, gets intercepted, drops kindly for him, gets another chance, and this time he bangs it down the ice and out of reach of anybody. Richardson with a tip out to Bergin on the left wing, right across. Cruikshank gets a stick in, it goes round the glass, bounces off the top of the boards, and all the way back down into Nottingham territory.
You've only got to watch who's got the legs.
Here comes David Clark. Soft one, pad save. That's a huge save, because when that's half deflected, it's not going at the speed you expected to. It's not going in the direction you expected to. And Cruikshank did really well there. Right to the front, Hull Stingrays have taken the lead, and it's that man, Costadine. Totally against the run of play. Corey Nielsen on defence with young Tom Norton, and Costadine was all alone in front, and we pay the price big style.
How many times have we been in our zone, Gary, in that 4 minutes, 48 seconds?
That's their first attack in nearly 5 minutes of the
Precisely.
Second period. James Cook, Nottingham boy, gets an assist on the play. Costadine is levelled at the face-off. He's Dan Tessier skating with purpose. Shoots, saved by Cruikshank, hangs on, takes the face-off. He's not going to take any risks. Mark Levers, who was involved in all that controversy when Kozak battered him from behind into the ice. He's gone. Costadine still here. Watch Paul Moran here. I bet you he goes straight up to and bangs as he does Cruikshank on the pads. He's done that since the juniors. Keep his goalie going. I don't know who taught him to do that, Johnny. Was that one of yours?
No, not one of mine at all, Gary. Too subtle for me.
I found some pictures. This is true. He won't thank me for saying this. Found some pictures of him in the juniors, and I've taken a set of pictures of you and him. You look awfully thin in the pictures, and he looks awfully young.
Those pictures take pounds off you.
Tessier and Moran, good friends in the past. Tessier gets up. He's upset. Paul Moran says, oh, take it, you're a pro. Now Paul Moran's got a penalty, so's Tessier.
Oh, they're having a word with each other.
Ah, well.
Penalty box sponsors, our solutions for accounting. If you're in trouble with your accounting system,
no comment. Takes after his mother.
Nottingham's award-winning Sage Business Partner.
I'm keeping quiet.
Penalty box is sponsored by PWP. Nobody gets past PWP security and access systems. Panthers main team sponsor is the GMB.
I'm not quite sure why there's any discussion about it. He wasn't calling the slash.
And then he checked it down to 4-on-4. Just leave it at 5-on-5. They didn't go.
To be honest, Johnny, it's the rule, isn't it? If it's 5-on-5 and there's one from each side, Tessier's picked up an extra one.
Hooking. Panthers number 26,
Dan Tessier, receives a 2-minute
unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for diving and a 2-minute penalty for roughing. Panthers 26, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike
sorry,
2 minutes
for roughing
and a 2-minute penalty for roughing. All those penalties timed at
25
minutes and
7
seconds.
And I don't think he was calling anything till he threw the half-hearted punch. Here we go, 2-on-1. Bounces over the stick of Slanina, takes the bad play, backed up, huge save. Molin just had to hammer that, bear down on it and put it in the back of the net, and somehow Cruikshank got the big mattress across and made the sliding save. Well, Slanina kicks it forward, but not under control, and Nottingham bring it forward. Brendan Cook, Hull Stingray's making a bad change on the fly. Well, a little bit of a juggle there, a little bit of a little from Curtis Cruikshank, but eventually Stingray's got it down the ice. Hull on the power play, remember. Matt Myers with three rays around him, pulls off a sting manoeuvre twice and helps win the puck. And Nottingham get it down the ice through Nick Toney's. Tip from Glower gets it all the way down the ice, but Danny Myers has lots of time to get it round to David Clark, but he tries to flick it out of the zone, and it's kept in there by Mitchell. Now Nottingham get it out of the zone. Hull get to it first. Slanina slips and falls, hand passes it to the wing. Bruce Richardson gets a piece of it. Glower gets a tip on it. Hull can't corral it, neutral ice, and Mark Richardson brings it forward, and Hull just force it forward. You can't tell who's on the power play. Hull, just with a line making up the numbers, as it were, don't have a power play unit as such. No icing, Nottingham short-staffed, just for 2 more seconds.
It's just that they seem to have had very few shots, and they've capitalised on the ones they've had.
Kalmykov nutmegs it to the corner. Corey Nielsen gets a chance to clear, uses the boards, gets it down the ice. Aaron Wilson, the American, goes back for it. Jamie Thompson gets a tip, no icing called. Esdes turns it in low. This isn't pretty, but Hull in effect are on a 38-minute kill. As soon as there's a whistle, 42 Paul Moran will be available to coach Rick Strachan. Here comes Nottingham, Galbraith, right across to the front. Wilson does enough to put Levers off. Moline gets to it though and gets it to Galbraith behind the enemy goal. Right to the front, goal, great goal. Danny Meyer sneaks into the play. He got the credit for the first goal when it was Fordy Gabenyuk. That's a good goal. And Danny Myers on a sweet feed from Galbraith ties things up at 2-2, sponsored by the Big Wheel.
Galbraith just held on to that. That was a sneaky little poaching pass. And then Danny Myers put it away well.
Has the dam been breached, Johnny?
Definitely, this is where we're going to turn. It's all downhill from here. Seems to have bred a little bit of life back into our supporters.
It was 5-on-5 play. There was a winger not doing his job on the far side for the whole Stingrays, and Danny Myers jumped in and fired home hard and low.
Goal for the Panthers, fourth of the season for number 19, Danny Myers.
Playmaker Jade Galbraith, who set up that goal, sends it deep into Nottingham territory behind Davis Parley. Nick Tonies fakes the shoot out to the left wing, instead feeds it to Matt Myers down the right. Half blocked by Moran into the corner, picked off by Slanina, uses the boards. Cook uses his body to win possession for Nottingham. Slanina trying to rob, and does successfully rob, Matt Myers. This is 3-on-2. Out wide to Costadine, the scorer for Hull. He finds a long-range shot on target, dealt with by Davis Parley. Nottingham come back the other way, 2-on-2. Jade Galbraith making room for the shot. Paul Moran gets to the rebound, gives it to James Cook, and he floats one to Costadine. Costadine is steered through the Panthers' gate, not quite into the bench. Others would have drilled him into that bench. Tight angle shot. Into the pads of Paul Moran, not for the first time tonight. Back door. Cruikshank tried to flick that one well out. Corey Nielsen, pad save.
As you said, I think the floodgates have opened now.
Slanina again tries to get it out of his zone like that and again gives it away. Reynolds is penalised. Panthers get the extra skater on with Davis Parley at the bench. Now Kalmykov touches.
It's a really clever ball by Galbraith to try and leave it. Hopefully back to the point, but it just didn't work, did it?
Interference, the call against Reynolds, and here's the power play that turns the game, Johnny. How's the training going for the Panthers versus Cancer Tilt?
Anyway, when they drop in the port, Gary. Everyone's aching, everyone's skating. I managed to get over the blue line last week.
Yeah, who's blue line? All right, face off to the left of Curtis Cruikshank. Nottingham have the draw. Galbraith, nice feed to Tessier. Cruikshank goes down, puck's loose. Gets protection, it's Brendan Cook anyway. Matt Myers, they don't do anything nasty and dirty in there. We're approaching the halfway mark of the game, but with Reynolds in the box for another 1:53, GMB Panthers have a power play opportunity to get in front. They actually gave an assist on Panthers' first goal to a guy sitting in the box. I gather that one's been changed. As it was Gabenyuk who scored off his own keeper's backside. I'm not surprised how anyone could claim an assist on the play, but whatever. Panthers are backing off here and giving Hull all sorts of time and room to kill, and it's right in front and loose. Now Nottingham can bring it forward. It's 3-on-3 though. Thompson gets back like a good pro, but here comes Nottingham, lots of room. Gabenyuk didn't even know he'd got it, but turns around and gets it and flicks one forward to that man, Jeff Glower. Shot deflected, goes wide. Danny Myers bumps into Davis. Parley. Nottingham on the power play for another minute. 60 seconds to take a grab on the game. Moline in the corner, Paul Moran tries to steer him. Bergin can't quite get good control of the puck, but gets it back to Moline. Hull operating the box. Nielsen across to Clark. Clark can't get the one-timer away. Mitchell making a nuisance of himself. Interception from Paul Moran, and the job's finished off by Mitchell. I think this is good power play from Nottingham, but I just think it's good kill as well by Hull.
Again, we've been camped in their side too many passes. Get the puck on the net. Bang.
Corey Nielsen with the shot from about 12 feet. Save. Richardson goes in the corner for it. Reynolds is coming out of the box. He's the danger period. David Clark deflected wide. Paul Moran gives Johan Molin a couple of feet of Coho. Molin through the legs, but deflected off Moran's pads. Nottingham still have it. Richardson in the corner. Mark Richardson shot, soft one. Comfortable save for Cruikshank. Another good kill by the Stingrays.
And again, we had all the pressure was in their zone. We didn't leave it, did we?
It's coming, it's coming. 7:52 to go.
Ken Feast was giving you a mention as well there, Steve.
Mark Richardson's shot squirted wide on the deflection. Mark Levers gets down the left wing and gets the puck into Tessier behind the Cruikshank cage. Ricocheting shot. Glauer got a piece of it. Levers got a piece of it. Ferreira. This must be about Ferreira's first shift of the game. Glauer can't win possession. Mark Levers couldn't stretch and reach. Ferreira's got it now. Stops, turns, gives it to Levers. Levers stops, turns, gives it to Glauer. Cook didn't mean to give it back to Glauer, but ended up doing, and it's flicked down the ice. Costadine sends it to the corner, tries to go and get it. Cook can't get to it either. Reynolds can't keep control for Hull, and here come the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Brendan Cook gets his wheels going in this one, sponsored by the Big Wheel. Tip from Reynolds, back pass to the keeper.
And the short sponsors are Dovgard Products.
Are we watching the same game?
Why?
Well, was that the back pass to the keeper?
I was being kind. I was taking the Michael. Hey, how are those ruminator sausages going up on Mansfield Road at Peebles
Butcher Shop?
Yeah,
really well. We've now got them on all the time. Every week people come in and ask for them. So, yeah, really good move.
See, that's what good marketing does for your son. Oh. Another clearance from Paul Moran, helped on its way by Jamie Thompson. Danny Myers throws it into the corner. Another clearance from Paul Moran. This one doesn't get over the blue line, though. Puck could go anywhere. It comes to Matt Myers. Floated in. Rebound. Oh, I think Reynolds could have taken more time on that one, but he's giving it away. Danny Myers sends it down the ice. That'll be icing, won't it? There's the whistle.
Tonight's 50-50 draw.
6:13 to go.
First prize currently stands at £252.
2-2 on the board. Boys need to relax now and not let frustration set in. That's the key now.
I think if you watch him, they're really trying hard, Gary. You've only got to watch him. Some of the pathers are a little bit in the front.
Goalie coach Lenz and bench coach Adam Goodridge have a key role in this one now. They need to calm the boys down and get the relaxation going so that, you know, that work with the sports psychologist they've done and what have you all kicks in. Best team by a mile, more bodies by a country mile, and it'll come. Glauer can't turn it in. David Clark gets it forward to Brendan Cook and gets it back, gets the favour return. Danny Myers is going to help it on its way with a backhand. Aaron Wilson reacts first, 6'4", 220-pound American. Took 222 minutes in 2 years, and the pros. Back door, Corey Nielsen tries to bunt it home, baseball style. Doesn't get bat to ball, as it were. Deflection. Oh, no one wants it. Hull want it. They clear it down the ice. Kalmykov. rubbed out on the boards by Clark. Puck's in Nottingham territory behind the goal. Tom Norton gives it back to his coach. Corey Nielsen, young Joe Graham up with the Lions in the northeast at Whitley Bay. Richardson's at the back door, blocked by Paul Moran. Well, that would have been easy peasy, but well read. Tom Norton has made a mistake. Costadine shoots a million miles wide. Hull in danger of getting called too many men, but 18. James Cook dived headfirst over the boards. Lob shot from Gamenyuk. Nottingham through Mark Richardson, don't clear the zone. Now they get it out. Paul Moran across D to Gamenyuk. Makes room for the return pass. Gamenyuk uses the boards and gets it forward to Costadine. Costadine mishits it, gives it straight to Tom Norton. He fires it through the feet of Tessier. Paul Moran takes his time, waits till he's got lots of room, gives it to Pash. Gamenyuk played together in Solihull in the BNL a couple of years ago for Rick Strachan.
Playing well, they did. Took big time strong there, man. Didn't just get rid of it.
They understand each other, they've played together well. James Cook takes his time, feeds it across to Reynolds. Reynolds has got better and better as the season's gone on. He didn't get hold of that one, but it squirted all the way through. Davis Polly just gets it to Ichorumen Nadir. It's a giveaway. Reynolds shot wide of the mark. Danny Myers nearly got his leg in the way. Who knows where it could have gone, but he got it out of the way. Slanina with his feet gets it down the ice. Ricochets in favour of the GMB Nottingham Panthers. We've got 37 minutes. This one's got the... No, it's not. They've got it away. It's given away there. Ichorumen Nadir reacts, uses the boards, chips it forward. Slanina puts a hand up, can't control it. Nottingham bring it forward. Brendan Cook gets a good handle on it and gets it in deep to Matt Myers. Can Matt Myers make something happen from there? No, the wall's chipped by the Hull Stingrays. Esders brings it forward. He had help. It was a 3-on-2 break with Wilson jumping into the play. Once control was lost, he wheeled off and went for a change. They're going for short shifts, as you'd expect them to with such a short bench. He's Kalmykov. Loses out. Slanina plays it back to Paul Moran. Back to Slanina. The makeshift defenseman flicks it forward. I think Mitchell got a tip. There's no icing call. Nottingham have possession. Nick Toney's turns away from Mitchell. Uses the boards. Doesn't get it passed properly. Nottingham pick it off through Corey Nielsen on the attempted diagonal dump. High in the air, lobbed in. Diagonal dump. Galbraith tries to get it back to Richardson. Paul Moran blocks the pass from Bergin to Richardson and then clears the zone.
Good job there. He's playing a very defensive game, Paul. They seem to be holding the game up. I don't know how they're doing it. And then they catch us.
Well, it's all breaks and high posting.
Yeah.
If they've got it, they're not really high posting tonight because it's all trying to get down the ice on a lucky break.
But they're
defending well, like you say. Paul Moran again, intercepts, gets it forward.
Another inch, that would have been on
his
stick.
He's now screaming at, his teammates, come on, we're all right. Kalmykov shields the puck, turns away. He's got the option of Paul Moran. Paul Moran backhands it to Gamenyuk. Gamenyuk uses the boards. Kalmykov swivels and gets control, uses the boards and flicks it down the ice. They're going to have to go for a change, even if it sells the defence short, but Paul Moran's got to the bench. James Cook's on there. Slanina's on there. Gamenyuk will need an iron lung when he gets back to the bench. Offside against Moline. They turn Nottingham and come out. We've had 39 minutes of play.
Gower again.
Offside whistle against the Hull Stingrays. Working hard, Hull, got to give them their credit. Nottingham working hard too.
Nottingham are working very hard. But we should be outworking them because of the strength of the bench. And it's as I say, every time number 9 gets the puck, you're scared what he's going to do. Very clever player.
It's something like his fifth year, isn't it? Fifth year in Hull, Jeff Glower. Nottingham break down the left wing with Brendan Cook. Here we go, here we go. Great time to score, last minute of the second period. In low, given away by Galbraith or blocked by Wilson, depending on which team you're supporting tonight. Flick to the front, Cook can't control it. Last 39 seconds. Oh, holding the stick, good. Matt Reynolds. He lost his stick and tried to grab hold of Brendan Cook's stick. If he'd ripped it out of his hands, the ref wouldn't have known which stick it was. As it is, it's a power play to the GMB Nottingham Panthers and a big one too. So we're sponsored by the Big Wheel, turning transport around in Greater Nottingham. Our thanks to Lucy and the gang at the Big Wheel for their sponsorship of both the game tonight and the shootout competition. Well, they've only called holding, but it was holding the stick, the official call. And on the power play, Nottingham have the chance to break the deadlock. Fighting low, Tessier feeds the front, it's deflected, it's over the blue line. 23 seconds to get something out of this power play. Icing against the GMB Nottingham Panthers on the power play. Sunday crowd started sitting on their hands, Johnny.
Yeah, well,
they're getting worried.
Yeah, they're getting worried because the whole holding is out, aren't they? With such a small bench. If you look at the players, they've even sat across the whole of the bench to make them look more.
Short-handed save. No whistle. Not even get the chance to play it forward to Jade Galbraith. Jade Galbraith fires it round. Cruikshank gets to it. Last 3 seconds. Hull run the clock down. We've had a 1-1 first period and a 1-1 second period.
And the scorer at the end of the second period tonight.
A little bit of a chat between Jade Galbraith and Jeff Glower.
I think it's Slovenia.
Slanina, sorry, yeah. Is involved in there. Johnny, it's always good to have you in the commentary box. We'll be back with the third period in just a moment. Tonight's game is sponsored by the Big Wheel, and we're about to have the big slingshot, slap shot, shootout competition, which we entertain the fans live at the NIC with at every home game. Good to see two contestants have actually turned up. Sarah from the office was worrying today when one of them didn't come to fill his forms in. It's 2-2 after two, though. Nottingham need a big third.
The players will be back after this short message from the Nottingham Building Society, headline sponsor of the Nottingham Panthers. Are you saving for your first home and thinking about getting on the property ladder? Are you aged 18 to 39? Would you like to see how you could get up to £1,000 free per tax year for your first home? Let us tell you about the Lifetime ISA. The Lifetime ISA is a savings account for 18 to 39 year olds who want a little extra help with their future savings goals. You can use it for your first home or wait until you're 60 and use your savings for retirement. The government will give you a 25% bonus on your savings. So you save £100, you get £25. You save £4,000, which is the maximum per tax year, you get £1,000 free, paid straight into the account, plus interest. You can open an account with just £10 online at thenottingham.com. Ineligible withdrawals are subject to a government charge of up to 25%. Check the terms and conditions for more information. Now, back to the Nottingham Panthers.
Tonight's BMI Baby Elite League game, sponsored by the Big Wheel, helping you get around Greater Nottingham between tonight's visitors.
Myers on the left wing, Chastier at centre, Cook on the right wing, Myers right deep, Galbraith on the other point. Power play for 84 seconds. Glower wins the draw. Hull send it down the ice. Time to set up, boys, and make the power play pay dividends. Offside against the Nottingham Panthers. There's no credit crunching here on a Sunday night. We need some goals.
Panthers will be in the foyer after tonight's game when they've had a shower.
Nice to be in the black.
So if you want to see them in the foyer with a copy of the calendar, any calendars that haven't been sold will be there. You can buy one and get it autographed by the GMB Nottingham Panthers. That's after the game tonight in the foyer.
8 players in the wrong position for the face-off. Brought back, Tessier wins this one, gets it across the ice. Galbraith has a look. Sends it forward to Matt Myers. Goes down the left wing, intercepted. Hull send it back down the ice. Dan Tessier gets past Wilson this time. He's recovered. He backhands it across. Comes back to him. Bounces over his stick. Kept in the zone, though, by Captain Danny Myers. Myers to Tessier. Tessier backhands it back to Danny Myers. Danny Myers goes high. A little bit too high. Glauer's got a chance to clear. Backhands it. But it's taken out of the air by Danny Myers, and he gets it across to Tessier. And now he sends Cook in onside. Brendan Cook back to Matt Myers. Matt Myers tries the one time, but Danny Myers can't get onto it. Hull bring it away. It's a foot race. It's Kalmykov going through, goes to the backhand and scores for the Hull Stingrays. Shorthanded, Hull Stingrays have taken the lead. We were talking about this power play being crucial, and shorthanded, you'd have bet your house on Kalmykov when he played for us. Kalmykov played for us in season 04-05 and had 26 goals in 44 points in 60 games. He's a proven goal-scoring machine. May not be at Hull for much longer, I hear on the grapevine. May have had a big offer come in. But right now, the Stingrays have silenced this Sunday crowd, and it's 3-2 to Hull.
Well, again, we've been all over them. We've kept the puck in their zone, and then they get that break, and he's away. Short-handed goal.
15 seconds of power play to try and balance the books. Cruikshank goes down, waits, kills another couple of seconds off, 12 seconds to go. I've just been working on a couple of club hotlines. Our own and Hull's are both in my stable, and I had to say on the Hull hotline that they're going to walk out of this building whatever the final score with their heads held high.
Yeah, we are to that.
Although I've been, you know, there's been application and effort from Nottingham. And when you come up against a hot goalie, it can get difficult. Paul Moran and Cruikshank together block the route to goal to the scoring channel. And Hull get their man back. Nottingham have the puck deep in their own territory. It comes rink wide to Corey Nielsen. Corey Nielsen over the head. Paul Moran and Bruce Richardson. Well, Mopes did enough, didn't he?
That's all he had to do, just time up for that second.
Gets it past two plays, it's sent in low by Mitchell. Actually, it was the other young Brit, Esders. Reynolds blocks it, can't take it forward. Into the far corner by Slanina and down the boards by Wilson. Now we have got an 18-minute kill on our hands for the visitors, haven't we?
They're just going to block the game. If you see what they're doing now, they're holding the blue line.
Backhand flick comes back off Wilson's pads. Nottingham get another chance, but this time it comes off Reynolds' pads. Reynolds takes his time, and the little tip from the left winger. Jamie Thompson gets it down the ice. Nottingham send it back in. Wilson's got time to corral this one, sends it across to Slanina. Reynolds backhands it forward. It'll be icing when Danny Myers touches it. They're trying to change quickly. Icing's waved off.
Waved it off.
Brendan Cook gets the wheels going. Poke checked. Slanina, soft pass forward, sent further forward by Mitchell. Kalmykov tries to feed it through. Nielsen tries to get to his own rebound, knocks it back down. He comes round three players, soft backhand. Good save by Davis Parley. Great thrusting run by Konstantin Kalmykov.
He's incredible. He's got to be the man of the game for them.
Oh, I've got a Brit and a British passport holder in my list ahead of them.
Oh, well. that could be favouritism.
No, I'm not Curtis Cruikshank's relative.
Oh, you reckon?
I mean, if it wasn't for those saves at the start of the game, they wouldn't be in this position they're in now. And the position they're in is leading by 3-2. High and handsome shot. Gamenyuk gets it to Paul Moran, uses the boards. Mitchell can't get to it. Danny Myers keeps it in the zone. Tip, bounce, Moran hammers it out to the right wing. Reynolds making a nuisance of himself. The pass still gets through to Clark, but his pass doesn't go anywhere. But onto the stick of Matt Reynolds. Reynolds sends one out to the right wing. James Cook loses his footing, gets back to his feet, finishes the hit on Mark Richardson, frees the puck up. Costadine turns it back behind the net. Cook goes for it, feeds point. Slanina in low. Bruce Richardson loses possession. Costadine loses possession. Bruce Richardson this time gives it away to Slanina. Well, Hull owner Mike Pack said to me before this one, tell your boys to go easy on us tonight. We're expecting the backlash from the defeat at Basingstoke. There's no need for double figures. I wish. 15 minutes to turn this one around. Knocked out of the air by Aaron Wilson. Nadeau sends it to the far side. Johan Molin, Slanina gets a piece of it. And Lee Esders reacts quickly and gets to it. Long range effort from Nick Toney. He's a long way off target. Gamenyuk can't get to the bouncing bomb. Levers gets it behind and low. And Tessier comes into the corner with it and then tries to feed it through the eye of the needle. Can't do it. 3-2, the Hull Stingrays lead in this one. Sponsored by the Big Wheel. And if ever we needed to turn our transport systems around, it's in this game. See what I did with that one, Johnny?
You did. You got that one. Incredible. Ad-libbing. What we need to do.
Hull reacting well under pressure, but they've given it away now. Bouncing bomb blocked on the rebound shot. Hull get a piece of it. Matt Myers. Hull get a chance to clear. Tenacious defending.
Oh, Hull are doing an incredible job. They're just forcing us out to the sides all the time. Not letting us get the good shots on, the quality shots on goal.
Same as in the second period, though. The trick is relax. Don't panic. Matt Myers breaks a stick, and that broke up the play. Now Brendan Cook's got a chance to take it in. Pokechek's coming around, then the hit comes in. From Wilson, Brendan Cook goes down. Kalmykov collects. 2-on-2. Costadine drives the net. Kalmykov, what a wrist shot. Nadeau throws a bit of a shot on him. Pucks in deep. No backlift on that wrist shot and had good speed on it. Like a Geneva shot. Those Swedes, when they came in, Johnny, had wrist shots as good as slap shots. Wilson's going for 2 minutes. Tripping's the call. Here's the chance to equalise. The penalty coming.
What do you say, the Swedes?
46-51. The Swedes, when they came in, their wrist shots, no backlift, just ding, and it was like a slap shot. Not as strong as your slap shots, Johnny.
I'm glad you said that.
Their wrist shots reminded me of your wrist shots.
Thank you.
How's that stick I got you?
Absolutely incredible.
How's those skates I got you?
Incredible.
How's the elbow pads I got you?
Even better.
And what about the gloves?
They're just superb.
You should see the shirt I've got you. They phoned me up and said, I'll do double, triple, extra large shirts and 2 goalie shirts. I said, make it 3 goalie shirts. Here's the power play for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Molin in the corner. Richardson, Corey Nielsen. Richardson, Corey Nielsen. Clark on the wrong hand for the one-hander. Extra penalty against Hull. 1:37. 97 seconds of 5-on-3. Here it is.
If we've ever needed the bounce, this is
it. Oh, it's Bergen. Is Bergen getting the penalty? One to each side. Paul Moran's going.
Sponsors are Solutions for Accounting. If you're in trouble with your accounting systems, call Solutions for
Is it one for each side or what? Award-winning Sage Business Partner. Bergen shakes his head. It's not 5-on-3. Well, they'll be coincidental, so it'll be 5-on-4 still in manpower. Might have suited Hull with their short bench to go 4-on-3.
You got to think, Nick Strachan is a happy man.
He's a big problem for Hull because they've got 2 defensemen in the box now. Don't forget they've got 2 defensemen sidelined through injury. Big hustle in the corner. Moline goes down at it. Fans want another penalty. Nottingham bring it out. Get it back to David Clark. Big blast off target. Goes wide. Corey Nielsen keeps it in. Bruce Richardson. Don't let us down, Bruce. Moline deep in enemy territory. Has a luck. Corey Nielsen realises there's no one at left point. Mark Leavers drops to that position. Corey Nielsen at right point. Moline has it. Gets it back to Leavers. Leavers tries to set up the player coach. Can't get the shot away. Bruce Richardson spins and turns and loses his footing, but gets the puck to Moline. Moline on the backhand, back to Richardson. Gloves it down and then gets it with a stick. Out to Leavers. Leavers can't keep it in the zone. 43 seconds of the kill to go. Still 5-on-4. Reynolds trying to get past. Mark Leavers back checking. 35 seconds of power play to go. Here comes Corey Nielsen. It's going coast to coast, folks. He's got it into the corner. He's got it behind the net. Gamenya gives it straight away. Back door. Gotta be. Great goal. Corey Nielsen finishes up. That's a 3-3 scoreline. Yes, we're back on level terms. Aaron Wilson comes out of jail. And that comes at 48-38. Good power play goal. Good power play goal.
Great goal. That's what we was needing. Curtis is still playing out of his skin. Let's hope that's broken him down a little bit. Seems like Corey thought, I'll take that. I'll take it by the scruff of the neck, coast to coast. And then the big shot in the back of the net.
Well, he was in the wrong position on the power play in the end because he'd gone in low, but teammates had covered for him back on the blue line and the setup still worked.
Corey Nielsen, assistant 26, Dan
Tessier. Ruben Nader is robbed, his pocket is picked. Here comes Jeff Glower for the Hull Stingrays. Sends it right across to Kalmykov. It's even strength. One guy from each team on coincidental minor penalty still in the box. Brendan Cook shapes as though he's going to blast it forward. In the end, controls it. Jade Galbraith blocked off by Wilson. Wilson gets it to Slanina. Slanina comes round the bodies and gets it forward to Young Mitchell. Brother plays for Edinburgh in the BMI Baby Elite League at the moment. Corey Nielsen, Taylor. Dan Tessier can't get it through Esders, literally. And we've got 10.5 miles to go in this one, sponsored by the Big Wheel, and it's a 3-3 scoreline. Mark Leavers back door! Big pad save, puck's loose, Cruikshank gets to it. Dan Tessier trying to force it in from 4 feet.
Incredible shift there, he tried to force that through. All five was going through there. You cannot knock the Nottingham team tonight. It's just the bounce hasn't been for us.
Bit of animated discussion on the whole bench. You don't often see that. Rick Strachan and Slava Kulikov. 10:16 to go. Hull get it out to halfway. Tessier with a chance to take Nottingham back into the attack zone. He gets it across. Leavers can't corral it. Johan Moline can. Backhand poke check by Gamenya. Giveaway by Hull. Haven't done that much tonight. Paul Moran gets a piece of it. Gamenya uses the boards. Can he get it past point? Yes, he can. Sent out to the right wing. Moline hasn't got control. He spins and turns. Gets it in low. Moline is levelled by Gamenya behind the play. The fans want a call. Leavers stays out wide. Danny Meyer's shot deflected by Jamie Thompson. Recent signing, Jamie Thompson, hasn't been high profile, as it were, but he's been solid for the Hull Stingrays tonight. Here comes Corey Nielsen. He's got one. Wants to inspire another. Cruikshank watches that one all the way and covers it. 9:10 to go. 3-3. The score. I wonder what's going through the mind of 82-year-old Jerry Watson, who played with us for about 5 years, from 50 through 55, 56. Only stopped playing rec hockey aged 81 last year, albeit in California. that probably just helped the blood flow at 81. You know, the California heat, then the cool breeze of the ice rink. Corey Nielsen keeps it in the zone. Glove down by Slanina. Backhands it up the boards. Linesman kills it down.
Well, with a bit of luck, we're going to pull up another point here. The way that we're playing, we've got to keep it in. Keep the momentum rolling from that goal by Corey Nielsen. Looks like Bergin's got an issue. Obviously, didn't think it should have been offside. I don't know, one of the players is down there tying his lace. There you go, he's getting a change. Makes you wonder if that was there on purpose. Young Cookie it was. He's dropping it now. We've kept him on the ice for this time. Try and get Clarkey to get his shot away. Here they come again.
Thanks, Johnny, filling in. The arena just talking to me at the same time as we're trying to keep an eye on the action here. Signing session to come after this one. Some queries from the NIC staff as to how we want it setting up.
Afraid I'm really busy, Gary. I've got to go after this. So can't stay for the signing.
Barry Burt will be there. He's in the calendar.
And he's going to be there. Was between him or one of the sheep out my shot, wasn't it?
Word for Ken Fees flying solo on the announcements tonight. Steve Machen enjoying the Spanish sunshine on a break from his department store duties. And Ken Fees, the bank manager. Well, he's a bit of an attack from Hull. Corey Nielsen knocks the shot down with his leg pads and then brings the puck forward for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Richardson's hit from behind on Kalmykov has drawn a 2-minute penalty. There's the whistle. Richardson shakes his head.
Similar infringement happened to Moline down there. Nothing happened. Then Richardson does the same and he gets 2 minutes.
I guess the difference was Richie did it under the ref's nose.
Yeah, true. And the difference is that we really don't like Richardson getting caught.
Not in a month of Sundays, but we'll just kill this and then we'll get the winner. Oh, it's gone in. It's a power play. Take the lead. Slonina to the front. And I think it was Matt Reynolds with a tip. Is that Matt Reynolds? No, it's Jamie Thompson. Moments after I said he hadn't been high profile, but solid and dependable.
He got a lovely tip in there. Not what we want to see.
Now it was an awful call. Now it was a dreadful call. Now it was the worst call of the night.
Without a doubt. I just hope the ref can sleep with himself. Well, you don't sleep with any other anyway.
Thompson the scorer. On the PP. 51 minutes and 53 seconds. 8 minutes to hang on to another dreadful upset. Giveaway by Nottingham. Moline. Costadine latches onto the puck, no icing called. Deflection, says the linesman. Reynolds gets it back to Costadine. Costadine thinks about giving it to Point, then leaves it for Reynolds. Battered out of the end zone by the GMB Nottingham Panthers, but possession. Oh, Wilson's made a hash of that. Tessier gets it to Moline. Moline tries to go round. Cruikshank. Cruikshank makes the save. Loose puck there, and we weren't digging for that. We were not digging for that. And Cruikshank hangs on to the shot from Nadeau at Point. In a game where you're losing 3-4 and there's a loose puck in front, you bust the gut. You snap your laces trying to get to that one.
You take the goalie through the back of the net after the puck's gone in. That's what you do. We just stood still there, didn't we? We don't seem to be hungry. And I can't believe I'm saying that about the team I love. We just don't seem to have any intensity.
K Kevin Bergen trying to make it happen for Jade Galbraith. He fans on the shot. Corey Nielsen keeps it in the zone. You know the pressure's coming now from Nottingham. Bergen gets it through traffic, but not all the way through on the target. Matt Myers to Brendan Cook, intercepted. Mitchell doesn't get it out of the zone. Paul Moran trying to block the route to goal. Forces it wide. Galbraith takes his eye off the puck. It goes right round the back. Glower gets a tip, sends it further behind. Brendan Cook gets a piece of it. Matt Myers tries to protect the puck from Paul Moran. Paul Moran half hits him. And together with Gamenyuk, they free the puck up and Hull bring it forward. Flicked forward by Kalmykov. They can smell blood now, the Hull Stingrays.
They seem to have gone up another gear, don't they? They do.
Well, same as Nottingham did when we equalised. Cruikshank tips it upstairs. Don't get a delay of the game call from the keeper tipping it up. 6:17 to rescue this one. Now it's time to get a little frustrated and feel a little uneasy, Johnny.
I don't know. I don't know what the call that Corey can make. Seems to have tried everything and they've just held us out. It's a bit like the Alamo.
Well, they've certainly stuck to their game plan. And they've tipped that one out of the zone as well. They've killed well tonight. Now they've got to kill 5-on-5 to the final hooter. That's a giveaway by Nottingham. Wilson touches it. Whistle goes for icing. Face off at the other end of the ice. Richardson argues it was touched. They're not going to change their mind.
Data storage. Trail alongside the Panthers at Virgin Active, the official health club of the GOP Nottingham Panthers.
Need to win this draw. Need to get some pride and passion going. Glower and Richardson with help. Nottingham win the draw. Danny Myers gets it up. Moline, nice backhand into the feet. Bruce Richardson loses it. Glower doesn't really win it. Costadine just gives it to Danny Myers. Nottingham onside. Danny Myers high over the bar. Good shot in rugby, not so good in ice hockey. Between the pipes, but over the bar. Richardson and Glower. Glower half wins it. Moline wins it for Richardson. Richardson to Nick Toney's tip right in front. David Clark can't put his rebound away. Round the glass and out the zone by the Hull Stingrays. How did Clarky not put his own rebound away there?
And that is the luck that we're having tonight.
Icing against the Hull Stingrays. We've got a face off to the side of Curtis Cruikshank.
I think if Hull win this, they think they've won the lottery. If they draw it, they'll think they've got five numbers in the bonus.
I think if Hull win this, Coventry and Sheffield will think they've won the lottery. And Belfast. Glower gets it across to the far side. Wilson reacts to the loose puck on Costadine's attempt to get it down the ice. Here comes Kevin Bergen. Dishes it off. Cruikshank did enough. Blocked the route to goal. Nottingham keep it in the zone. Matt Myers backhand. Kevin Bergen! Save Curtis Cruikshank.
It was a great setup. Wonderful passing. And a really good shot.
He's hot tonight. The Crooker.
Let's not put it away yet. Let's not put it to bed. It's 4:40 to go, Gary. All we need is a little bit of magic. A little bit of magic.
Kept in the zone by Nick Toney. Sets up the point man. Danny Myers back to Toney's. Toney's back to Myers. Myers backhands it in low. Brendan Cook, he's the goal. David Clark comes out the other side. Paul Moran had two attackers tied up. They came the other way. No one went with them.
All we needed was that bit of magic. I could feel it, Garrett. The momentum was building up. I could feel it coming. We're going to win. We're going to win.
4:27 to go. They've put the goal up on the wrong side of the scoreboard.
This isn't good.
Well, They're having an argument about it. What on earth is wrong with Mick Leavers down there? Finally. Icing against the whole Stingrays. Well, I couldn't believe he missed that rebound a few minutes ago, but he's made amends there. We're tied at four with 4:24 to go.
Incredible goal. Pulled it back. Thought he was going on his backhand. Turn around, top corner. What a goal.
3 seconds. 5-5-3-3. Hull clear the zone. It's gone all the way down to Davis Parley. Nick Tonies has a look. What are the options? He skates with it a little bit, gives it to the goal scorer, David Clark. Just scored our fourth goal for a 4-4 game with 4 minutes to go. He's winding up for another shot. Pad save by Curtis Cruikshank. Saw that one coming. Corey Nielsen keeps it in the zone. Through traffic, Cruikshank's got it. Paul Moran, David Clark, gone. Stick tied up. Here come the fans. Here comes the roar. The louder the roar, the bigger the score.
And to be truthful, Ezra the Sharrett's gone for most of the game.
Given that he's only got two lines, I don't suppose Rick Strachan, the Hull coach, another former Panther, of course, really needs a timeout. He can tell them each time they come off.
Yeah.
He might take a timeout to freshen up some legs. Glower and Tessier. Tessier wins it. Now Wilson has a chance to clear off the back of the net. He's got it. He's got some time. He has a look. They're not exactly racing forward, the black-shirted and silver-shirted Hull Stingrays. Nadeau, though, in a tangle. Glower's won it. Thompson round the back to Costadine. I suppose Hull will look on it as a draw will do, because anything can happen in the lottery of 4-on-4 sudden death and penalties. Slanina does well, ignores the incoming challenge, and this time gets it out of the zone. Across the front, stick by Parley, knocked out of the air by Moline, and Nottingham come forward. Hull a little stretch, changing on the fly. Moline keeps possession, spins and turns. Puck's loose, Moline goes down, ref says nothing this time. Tonies keeps it in the zone, but then gives it away. It's in the feet of Kalmykov, he digs it out. Good hands. And he's stick-handling his way through, backhand shot, deflected wide by Tonies, 2.5 minutes to go. Corey Nielsen uses the glass, it ricochets badly, and now Nottingham have steamed down the ice. Paul Moran gets in front of Brendan Cook. Deflection could go anywhere, comes up Cook's stick, I think, or pads. Galbraith gets it to Brendan Cook. Matt Reynolds has broken his stick in that challenge. Matt Reynolds can only try and play football with it. Bodies go down. Frozen puck. Hand pass by Nottingham. Face-off comes outside the zone. 2:12 to go.
Well, this is a fantastic end. It's going both ways. And we just want to see a white shirt score. Be a fit into a great game.
2:12 to go, 132 seconds. Glower wins the draw, takes it forward, dishes it off to Costadine, goes looking, deflection by Nadeau, hits the netting, we'll have a face-off at the wrong end of the rink.
2 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in regular.
So what's the rumour about this player leaving Hull then?
There's talk of a big money offer having come in and what have you. But you know what? I was going to ask you a question. 2:05 to go. I'm not a fan of overtime and penalties. I know it's I feel it's an engineered, a manufactured, exciting end to a game. We should be going for this. Penalty coming on the play against the Nottingham Panthers. Jamie Thompson can't get his stick to that. As soon as David Clark plays it, that's a bad, bad call. Now that is a dreadful call.
Panthers, home penalty box sponsors, our solutions for accounting. If you're in trouble with your accounting systems, call...
Clark and Nielsen inviting Costadine for a soda pop after the game.
They must eat the same steak at the same steak bar, eh?
You know, that's a bad, bad call. You don't do that with 1:51 to go and what have you. I was going to ask you about, because the sudden death overtime and penalties to come, I think it forces teams into, Hull would settle for a draw tonight, but it forces teams into, let's not make any mistakes, let's not go for it, you know. And it just brings that boring section further forward into a different time zone. All right, Strachan's calling for his timeout.
And you know he was going to do that.
I don't think he's going to get it. The referee says he's called for it too late. Reynolds has to take the face off. Soft, it's into the glove. Parley puts it down. Bergin sends it down. No, he doesn't send it down the ice. Hits Mitchell. Reynolds gets a piece of it. Levers doesn't get it out of the zone. It's battered out of the air, knocked down. And finally, Nottingham get it out. And it's Bruce Richardson. We've seen a shorthanded goal already. Bruce Richardson overcooks it, and the Hull Stingrays bring it forward. Kalmykov twists and turns away from Levers, gets it into the attack zone. Come on, boys, hold out, take the draw, get it in sudden death. Reynolds sends it to the corner to Mitchell. Young British forward doing well. Not there, though. That put the kibosh on his last shift in regulation. 65 seconds to go. Hull on the power play. And the Hull Stingrays, bottom of the table, in danger of getting a point out of the National Ice Centre against the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Gimena. Oh, wicked ricochet. It hit the post on the end of the stanchions. The hit from behind by Nadur sent Thompson sprawling into Meyer's feet. He's kept them, come forward, but lost the puck into the feet of Jeff Glower. Glower turns it back. 25 seconds in regulation. Costadine tries to send it to his D-man. It's loose, but Brendan Cook doesn't have a stick. Slanina turns it right across. Gamenyuk goes out over the blue line. 10 seconds to go. Nottingham short-staffed. Here comes Nick Tonies. Send it, son. Tough target. Cruikshank plays it. Fans on it. Huda goes. That's a 4-4 draw in regulation. 1-1, 1-1, 2-2 the period scores. That is, to all intents and purposes, a massive point for the Hull Stingrays and a massive point dropped by the GMB Nottingham Panthers. But they can rescue it if they win in sudden death overtime.
The Nottingham Building Society, along with our partners, providing you with all your financial needs, including savings, the lifetime ISA, mortgages, and home insurance. Visit thenottingham.com to find out more about how we can help.
Five minutes of 4-on-4, the first 9 seconds only of which the man at the Panthers bench with the chalkboard in his hands will start in the timekeeper's jailhouse. He's in the jailhouse now. Well, we like to give value for money, but I don't like the idea of giving everybody 65 minutes of play against the bottom of the table Hull Stingrays. But I have to say, the former Nottingham contingent, yeah, you're right, I'm biased in more than one case, because I like all the Nottingham lads that are back with the Hull Stingrays, all of them. But I have to say, they can walk out of this building with their heads held high tonight.
Oh, yeah.
They've had an outstanding short bench performance, just what you expect. And Rick Strachan should be patting everyone on the back and having a word with every one of them in the room, telling them they've done a job for him tonight.
Yeah. I'm sure he will do. Look at the size of the bench, Gary. That's on its
own. What do you do, Johnny? You've coached a little bit. What do you do about motivating a team against the bottom half of the table? Because that, in a general picture, am I right, Steve Wilkinson, the cameraman? That's our general problem, isn't it? There's no problem against the big teams. Sheffield's and what have you, and Coventry's. We get stuck in, we get going. But it's when we're playing the Basingstokes, the Edinburghs and the Hulls.
The problem is, Hull's coming here, and it's like Mansfield Town going up to Man United. We've got a lovely bond, the best bond in the country.
You just flown to that island with the little guy as the waiter, haven't you? And what have you, you know, Mansfield Town at Man United.
and they come here and they're already up for the game, as you've seen.
It's their cup final, isn't it? They come into this building, they're short-staffed, it's a lovely arena. We've got something like 3,500 people in here on a Sunday afternoon. That's more than three times as big as their biggest crowd of the season.
And the incredible commentary. That goes...
Yeah, they can't hear the commentary, Johnny. You're still on Fantasy Island, aren't you? All right, here we go. It's 4-on-3 to Hull for 9 seconds. Then Corey Nielsen joins Danny Myers at the back for the GMB Nottingham Panthers. Glower and Richardson. Glower wins the draw. Gets it back to Slanina. He's done well on defence tonight, Slanina. Fires it down, but Kalmykov can't control it with a big size 13 boots. Right, it's 4-on-4. Here we go. Time to start now. Let's get the extra point, Nottingham. Mark Leavers, block shot. Slanina's interference with the stick sends it wide, and Slanina now goes to get it from Wilson. Gets it forward to Kalmykov. In this situation, I kind of wish Kalmykov was playing for us. Nick Tonies does well. Good job by Nick Tonies, the Derby University student. Wins the puck. And Nottingham get it forward to Bruce Richardson. Inside to Moline. There's some speed. Moline twists and turns. Tries to block. Falls over. Hull flick it forward. Thompson just wanted a soft little feather pass. Glower possibly too tired to have a soft little feather pass. Corey Nielsen sends it in low. Moline goes to try and collect. Icing's the call against Nottingham. Face-off comes. We've had a minute of 4-on-4 sudden death. Face-off comes to Nottingham's end of the rink. The point I was trying to make, Johnny, about sudden death and the extra point, 4-on-4 is so cautious because you're frightened. You don't want to make the mistake that leads to the goal.
Leaves a big gap.
There's a lot of room out there on the National Ice Service ice centre surface. This isn't the old Market Square. There's an awful lot of ice out there. Here comes Tessier trying to use that surface to his advantage. Tries to turn inside. He's lost possession. No call. Referee's put his whistle away. 3.5 minutes. Left in overtime. Shot. Pad save. Reynolds couldn't get to it. Thompson couldn't get to it. It's come out. Thompson overcooked that one. And it's coming to neutral ice. And the Hull Stingrays are blown down for offside. Now the fans are on the edge of the seat. They used to play ice hockey in London. Stopped playing there 3 years ago. The best thing about the London ice hockey team was their catchphrase, their slogan. We'll sell you a seat, but you'll only use the edge of it. As in edge of the skate. Best thing, of course, can't really start your campaign with that because people don't know enough about ice hockey. They don't know anything about it. That there's an edge on your skate and all the rest of it. But nice line. Glower right in front, tips it. Loose puck, shot behind by Wilson. That's why he's a D-man. David Clark. Goes through Slanina. Puck goes too far the other way and Wilson can come the other way. This is my point. No one goes driving in because you have to get back just in case. Glower. Officially onside. Glower soft. Backhand behind the net. Nadir. So strong. Glower's stick pops out of his grip. And Nadir sends Myers forward. Behind the plate. It's taken off the end of his stick, but Myers goes to get it. Slanina trying to see where the puck is. Myers shields it, has a look. Oh, he's overcooked that one. Now it's Slanina, the forward turn defenseman. He's left the puck. Tonies was dealing with Slanina. The puck was there. Kosterdine's reacted and gone for it. Corey Nielsen goes to try and get him. Kalmykov jacks it in deep. We've got just over 2 minutes to go in sudden death and then we're going to go to penalties. Well, they're still all getting ice time for the whole Stingrays. They only had 4-on-D. Bruce Richardson gets past. It's right across. Cruikshank helps the D out. Tired legs, as you'd imagine. That came out. Myers touches it. Offside. Myers argues it came off the linesman. Referee Marco Koonen tells him to button it. 1:57 to go in sudden death overtime. We had a 4-4 scoreline in regulation.
Well done, Danny. Keep quiet. Don't get sent off.
Yeah, but you know what? Sometimes we're too quiet. I like the respect idea. You know, there's all this fuss in football about respect of officials. But in our sport, sometimes you have to give them what for so that you might get the next call that could go either way. The other teams are doing it all the time.
I'm off the soapbox now,
don't worry. It's just a pet thing. I understand what you're saying. I understand it can go either way. He's Bruce Reynolds. Which way is this game going to go? Danny Myers gets a stick in, breaks it up. Jamie Thompson shields the puck, gives it away. Paul Moran gets it in low. Davis Parley plays it, backhands it. Danny Myers feeds it forward. Dan Tessier, is it Dan the man? Out to Bergen. Paul Moran goes across, has a whack at it, wins it. Ricochets off Bergen, keeps possession, gets it to Moline. Dan Tessier flicks it inside to Moline. Moline, softest of shots. And Curtis Cruikshank says, with 76 seconds to go, we'll have a face-off. It's been entertaining.
I think it's been a really good
game. So was our game here a week ago, and I haven't got over that one yet. You don't score 6 goals and still lose in my book.
Only if the other team scores 7.
Sorry?
Only if the other team scores 7.
Or more. They did score 7, yeah. Atrocious. Atrocious. Guys didn't turn up for 60 minutes. They turned up for 20 minutes last night. I actually think they've turned up for the whole of this one. Sadly, so have Hull. All 11 of them. Plus the goalie. 70 seconds. Can David Clark magic something out of this? Glower gets just enough on it to get it over the blue line. Slava Kulikov on the whole bench urges his team forward. It's got to be hard to make your legs go forward in 4-on-4 sudden death at the end of 6 hard periods of hockey. Can count this as a 7th period. Slanina goes to the corner to get it. Bruce Richardson tries to harry him. It's just given away by Selina. Will he pay the ultimate price? It's given away by Nottingham and it's chipped forward. Mitchell can't get it. David Clark's got Nick Toney's jumping into the play. Poke check from that man, Jeff Glower. Referee gets in the way and he keeps it in the zone, but Glower gets a chance to bring it forward now. 26 seconds. Okay, let's take penalties, boys. Let's not panic. Davis Parley gets a piece of it. Slanina jumping into the play at the back door. Can't get to it. Glower and Nielsen both miss the puck. Wilson latches onto it. Fires it across the face. Last 8 seconds, it needs a shot, Matthew. Come on, you Welsh wizard, you! Intercepted pass, drops for Kevin Bergen. Bouncing bomb, steered to the side. We're going to penalties.
Gary, they've only played 3 periods, not 6.
6 on the weekend. They had 3 torrid periods in Manchester last night.
Torrid.
We had 2 tepid periods in Basingstoke.
I know.
All right, we're going to the shootout. Cruikshank versus Davis Parley. 4-4 after 65 minutes of entertaining, but at times frustrating ice hockey from the GMB Nottingham Panthers viewpoint. Our sponsors, The Big Wheel, will think it's like this every week. They're newcomers and they probably won't know. Konstantin Kalmykov, he's good at this. We've seen him on a breakaway already tonight. This is a key one for Davis Parley. Stands with his arms spread, the fans boo. Kalmykov shoots and it's saved as he goes for the 5-hole. Advantage Nottingham.
You'd have put money on, wouldn't you?
Here comes the Swede in the white boots, Johan Molin. Let's go, Moli, let's go! Johan Molin collects the puck centre ice, up against former Panther Curtis Cruikshank. He's had an outstanding game. And it trickles through the 5-hole. I don't think he meant to shoot that soft, but it's gone in. Double advantage, Nottingham. Next up for the Stingrays, number 9, Jeff Glower. Here comes Jeff Glower against Davis Parley. Hull Stingrays assistant captain in his 5th season with the club. He's got one already tonight on a rebound. Penalties favour the goalie. Hits the post. This for the game now. Jade Galbraith for the game. It's all over if Jade Galbraith puts this one away and Nottingham get the extra point. valiant effort by the Hull Stingrays, but even though we've got friends in their camp, this is what we want. Galbraith to score. And has he given it? Back of the net and out, he scored. I thought for a moment it had hit the pipework. Nottingham win it.
How easy did he make that look? How easy did he make that look?
Oh, he's got sick hands. Sick hands, that's a modern word, Johnny, for very good.
Brilliant.
Where would you put your money on man of the matches tonight? Where would you go for man of the match, Johnny, if you were the big wheel?
I'd definitely go for the number 19, the guy who's up for money.
Konstantin Kalbikov.
Yeah.
And for Nottingham?
For Nottingham, it's a hard thing. I've got to go for Clarke.
Pulling that goal. He pulled that goal.
Goal was a big goal, you're right there. We'll let you see which way the big wheel has gone as you enjoy the celebrations. It was exciting, and at the end of the day, it was 2 points for the GMB Nottingham Panthers and a very, very well-earned point for the visiting XL Hull Stingrays. They should leave this building with their head held high, but there was effort for 60 minutes, and Steve Wilkinson filmed the whole 60 minutes, as he always does. Johnny Pushdown, Gary Moran on the microphone, Steve Wilkinson on the camera lens. Good camaraderie. Look at the boys at centre ice shaking hands with former colleagues and former friends and former teammates. Good game, entertaining for more than 3,500 people. I can't think of a better place to be on a Sunday afternoon. I hope you've enjoyed another DVD presentation from your GMB Nottingham Panthers. Nottingham win it after penalties by 5-4.
These are presented on behalf of our match sponsors, The Big Wheel, by Lucy Grissom, Helen Clayton and Katie Saxon. The Green King IPA man of the match for the Stingrays, number 5, Steve Slonina.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to show your appreciation for the XL Hull Stingrays as they leave the ice, have a safe journey home, Hull, and to your supporters, thanks for coming.
And the Greeking IPA, another match for the GMB Panthers, number 19, Danny Myers.
Top cat, the most effectual top cat, who's intellectual, close friends get to call him TC, providing its with dignity. Top cat, the indisputable leader of...
And ladies and gentlemen, now centre ice, please show your appreciation for the GMB Nottingham Panthers!
Thank you.
time. You can see the GMP Nottingham Panthers is next Saturday night as they take on the Newcastle Vipers. And remember that the calendars are on sale tonight after the game, and the players will be available in the foyer for a signing session for both calendars and anything else brought from the shop or the stands tonight. See you then.
Do what you do in the comfort of your own home, knowing that the things most precious to you are protected. Talk to the Nottingham Building Society today about a free home insurance review. Happy dancing!